For this to have been nothing more than a hypothetical question, he got so invested in the argument that two people that are exes can live together underneath one roof and it is completely copacetic. And I was like, you know what, honestly, be that as it may, but if that's something that's going on, are you creating a scenario where it's a known fact beforehand that that's what's going on? Because I just don't, I don't understand. I've seen this happen many, many times. It is not to say that it's not possible, but it is a major red flag when someone tells you that they reside with their ex. You know what I mean? It's just kind of like, you know, if you ever get lonely or you're horny, there is a warm body down the hall. You know what I mean? It's just too close for comfort. It was really, really weird to me. And he was just like so invested in his perspective and his standpoint on the conversation. And at the end of it, I was just like, you know, honestly, it doesn't even matter. It's a hypothetical question. So like, why are we arguing about this? One thing he was very, very good at and well known for was creating or talking about hypothetical situations to pretty much, I felt like he was baiting me into stupid arguments with hypotheticals, which just didn't make any sense. I'm just like, why are we arguing about things that don't matter? It is totally okay to have open dialogue and ask different questions about different scenarios because it gives you a good feel for a person. It gives you a good feel for your partner in different circumstances. But this one in particular, it was like one of our first heated, just like silly debates. That one always stuck with me. So when January came and that fire had happened, and his daughter's mother flew from California home to Jersey to help with an intervention, for some reason the conversation in November like just sparked my interest, like resurfaced, and I was just like, I'm just wondering. And then I was like, if I hadn't seen the photo, I would have questioned whether or not there really was a fire, because the wheels in my mind were spinning. And I got to thinking, maybe she was always scheduled to come fly to Jersey in January and you knew it in November and you tried to pretty much get a feel for where I would stand on the matter because she is your ex. But that couldn't have been furthest from the truth as to what I know now. So anyway, he said that there was extensive damage done to the kitchen, so the kitchen could not be cooked in. And he also mentioned that the insurance was covering a hotel stay for he and his daughter and his daughter's mother to stay at until the property was fixed and it could be, you know, accessed again and they could live in it again. He would either stay at my house or he would actually just stay at the house because the house wasn't condemned. So he was like, my daughter and her mom are staying in the hotel because it's kind of small, so it only makes sense for me to either be at your house or just stay at home. So he was between those two places. And they did find out that the fire was actually electrical and it wasn't his daughter. And they were working on getting it fixed every single day. Every day they were in there trying to put the kitchen back together. Because I knew that he could not use his kitchen, I always made sure that he was fed, because where else are you going to be able to prepare food, you know? I felt like my house might be the only place that he could go to get a home-cooked meal. And he just went through like a huge tragedy because fire damage is expensive. So I wanted to be supportive and not be selfish at this moment in time, because it wasn't about me. His property was damaged. The house was damaged. It was a major inconvenience and people could have been hurt. So I was just grateful that everyone made it out safe and everyone was okay. But I understood the inconvenience of, yesterday I had a kitchen to cook in, I could access my refrigerator, plug in my microwave and use it, and now I can't. So I knew it was a big change and it was a hardship, and he was so stressed out about it. He was like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I said, if you need help with something pertaining to your kitchen, just come and talk to me, because I know that you have to pay something towards a deductible for your insurance to kick in and start remodeling and rebuilding the kitchen or whatever the case may be. So I let him know that I was there, I was gonna be supportive and helpful, and I understood. I understood the frustration. Not because I had a kitchen burned down before, but because I've started a lot of fires before and damaged some stuff. It was all by an accident.